Howdy folks, how you doing? Well, smoking my little Sure Jacopo Dublin. I'm done with the words family, guys. Got a little plateau top on there, it's kind of nice. Well, I'm here to talk about why I exploded on Pipe Friend's video. Some of you may have seen it, some of you may have wondered. I apologize to Pipe Friend in advance for having a meltdown on this video. But there's a reason why, at least in my mind anyway. It goes back a few weeks ago. I was watching a video of a Kibatayos, and it was about these skulls they'd found with, like, the teeth were completely worn down. Really ugly looking things, and really nasty looking, by pipes, by clay pipes. And her video was about clay pipes, and I've always found clay pipes fascinating, and one day I do intend to buy one. I've seen these great big long ones on eBay, and I almost bought some, but not quite. One of these days. One of those things I don't really want that much, so just something I kind of want, but not enough to actually spend money, because money's tight, so anyway. So on that thread, the pipe writer, out of the blue, posts a comment saying, about these ugly skull videos with, photos with these horrible looking teeth. He said that's what Pipe Friend's teeth are going to look like, basically, because he clenches so much or something. But it's okay, he'll be able to afford a dentist because of his childless lifestyle. Which kind of struck me as a little homophobic, perhaps, because everyone knows Pipe Friend's gay, he's open about that. It struck me as a little bit me homophobic, or something, and at least kind of a rude comment, or something. And Pipe Friend wasn't even posting to that video, so it's not like he was there. But it struck me as a little bit odd, and it struck Ty as a little odd. So she wrote back and said, you make that sound like a bad thing, she obviously struck her as kind of a homophobic comment, at least a jab at Mark for no reason. That his teeth are going to look that way, and then that, it's okay because of his childless lifestyle, he'll be able to afford it, having to afford the dentist or whatever, or something, but it just seemed like a strange comment, to take a poke at someone, especially someone who wasn't there. So Key wrote back and said, I know what you're referring to, and, maybe it's not so nice or something, I don't know. And then he just outright insults her. Just says, get a job, And then makes a nasty insult, at her, And I wrote, and then she writes, maybe this isn't the best place for you to be if you're going to be rude. And I wrote to Pipe Writer, in return to his comment about get a job. I wrote, dude, why are you hating on Ty? That's not cool, And, and I figured that was the end of it, I figured anybody could have a brain fart, maybe, and maybe he didn't mean it as homophobic, though. Even if it wasn't a homophobic comment, it wasn't a particularly nice comment toward Mark, And I'm not a liberal person, or I'm not one of these knee-jerk liberals, as everyone probably knows. I'm a libertarian. But I don't think too much of racist or homophobic comments, I wasn't raised that way, and, Anyway, so, but I let it go, So, within a week, Pipe Writer's over on my channel making rude comments to me, all of a sudden. Within a few days, and these comments aren't comments disagreeing with what I was saying or disagreeing with the philosophy. These are just smart ass, comments directed at me, which I don't think was very nice. So I wrote Ty and said, this guy's clearly got a problem, he's at it again. I said, just to let you know. And she said, yeah, I know, I blocked him. And I said, well, I'm blocking him too, because I don't want this jackass on my channel, making comments to me or anybody else like that, because this is the pipe community, you know, we get along here, you know, we don't do that to each other, you know, and what really kind of pissed me off about this, much anything else, is the fact that this guy, the pipe writer, was welcome, was given a warm welcome, you know, by the entire pipe community when he showed up. I think he made a couple of videos, I think, in retrospect. But now his channel, if you look at it, it's just a typical, you know, a typical trolls channel. There's no name on it, I don't think. There's no videos, nothing, you know. A few other things are filled out. So, but I figured that was the end of it, you know. You know, and I underestimated the blocking abilities of, or overestimated the blocking abilities of YouTube's blocking thing. So, a few days later, he finds me on Pipe Friend's video, which was about this smoking study. And all I was saying in that study, by the way, on that video, you know, my comments were just saying, you know, let's find out who made the study. Let's find out, you know, who was included in the study before we really, you know, take it too seriously, because scientific studies can be junk science, you know. And it could be real, it could be, you know, good information, but it could be, you know, who knows. So the pipe writer makes a smart-ass comment to me there. And I had had a particularly nasty day that day. I had a very disappointing day indeed, as a matter of fact. And I came home, and I, you know, I made this comment about, let's, you know, let's check into this study, you know, and see where it's from, who made it, you know, and who was included. And by the way, I could be wrong with this, but it looks like to me the study was half cigarette smokers who also smoked pipes. That's how I took it to be. When I actually researched the study itself, I could be wrong about that. Well, if that's the case, then it doesn't really have anything to do with us. And what I was really saying in that video, that commentary, was, is it possible that these are pipe smokers who inhale? Because it's a very different thing, you know. Because every study, several years ago, when I went and Googled and found a bunch of scientific studies, medical studies, in journals and stuff, on pipe smoking, every single one was about pipe smokers who inhaled. They don't want to study pipe smokers who don't inhale, you know, obviously. And so, you know, that's what I was curious about, you know, and that's why I'd comment basically. Well, you know, once again, the pipe writer's got to make a smart-ass comment to me. Okay, Dr. Kill. He's not commenting on what I was saying. He's commenting at me. He's making a smart-ass comment to me, like I'm some guy, an idiot, for questioning, you know, the study, you know. It's not a comment about, you know, hey, Kel, you know, how do you know? What are you going to do? He's not disagreeing with my principle or my idea. He's just making a smart-ass comment directed right at me. And I'd had a bad day, and I was no longer in the mood for any bullshit, okay? Because this guy's been blocked. He knows he's been blocked. He knows I don't want to talk to him. He knows I don't want him bothering me. He knows, you know, he knows that. Damn well he knows that, you know. But he's going to come after me on other people's channel, because I didn't realize that even if you block someone, they can still reply to your comments. And he's going to make smart-ass comments to me, you know. And I hate trolls. And that's what he is. He's a troll. He goes around making little snide comments directed at people, not the subject matter, you know. And he makes these comments, you know, and then, of course, he gets people all riled up, which is what he wants. He wants to get people pissed off, you know. It's what he's doing. And, you know, that's to be expected on other YouTube channels, you know, in the regular YouTube community. You know, people are arguing politics or whatever, you know, that kind of would be expected. But that's not really something we do in the pipe community, you know. And for a guy to come in here, get a warm welcome as he received, okay, and then start this kind of crap for no reason I can see, I find it thoroughly disgusting. And I find trolls disgusting, which is what I believe he is. I find trolls disgusting. I find them cowardly. Because they run around pulling this shit they would never pull in real life. He would never talk that shit to my face. And you know why. You know, this kind of guy would never talk that shit around regular people, around men, amongst men. But he'll go do this shit, hide behind a computer screen and do it, you know? And I find that thoroughly disgusting beyond belief, frankly. So I reacted, you know, I reacted, partially in hope that he would get the frickin' message to, you know, go away, you know, and because I had a very disappointing, irritating day, and I wasn't in the mood for any more shit today from anybody, especially someone who shouldn't be doing it in the first place, someone in the pipe community, you know. In my opinion, when someone does that in the Pike community, they're just pissing all over our community, you know. And I don't like it. I think it's disgusting. I want to thank, and that's why I said what I said, if anybody's wondering. I wasn't just crazy, I'm not just nuts. It had been a long line of bullshit from him and comments on my channel that I deleted, you know, instantly, and then blocked him, but eventually. But, thing is, first thing I got in a message was from Salam saying he'd block him. He saw it went on and Salam would block him, and I appreciate that. A month or two ago when Salam was being harassed by somebody, I blocked that guy immediately, because that's my policy. If someone's, you know, running around trolling, they're done on my channel. They're blocked. If they're trolling on somebody else's channel, they're blocked. They bother my friends, they're blocked. It's that simple, you know. Also, I want to thank Chard Breyer personally, too, because he blocked him as well immediately. So, to Salam and Chard Breyer, I really appreciate that. I appreciate the solidarity, you know. You know, someone can run around and troll like that and pull that kind of crap and make those kind of nasty comments, and there's really no consequence except for being blocked. And we've had this before in the Pike community where someone's decided they're going to run around and they're going to stir up shit for no reason, you know, and they've been roundly blocked. I think it's a good idea. It's my policy, anyway. Anyway, so I'll let you know why I went nuts. I was pissed off anyway, and then that was just the last damn straw from this guy, you know? I was mad for myself, but I was also mad for the community, you know? Because we don't need that here, you know? I don't need it here anyway. If I had another regular channel, you know, if I had a regular YouTube channel, I'd expect that. I wouldn't care, and I'd just delete the comments, or I'd just ignore it, and I wouldn't care. If I had a regular channel, I wouldn't be commenting in the first place. I wouldn't be actually talking to people, you know, in the forums the way I do, in the comments the way I do. Because I consider this my home. I consider these people my friends, you know? You know, if I had a regular channel that was like I had for some business purpose or for some, you know, other reason or to become famous or something, in a real way, I wouldn't, it wouldn't, it'd be different. But this is the Pike community, for heaven's sakes. Long may it wave. Right, folks? I'll talk to you later.